हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द अनदर वीडियो ऑफ स्टार्टअप एंड रिकमिशनिंग ऑफ कुका रोबोट। लेट्स कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम मास्टरिंग विद द MEMD एंड मार्क। ओवरव्यू: इन MEMD मास्टरिंग, द एक्सिस इज ऑटोमेटिकली मूव्ड बाय द रोबोट कंट्रोलर टू द मास्टरिंग पोजिशन। मास्टरिंग इज कैरिड आउट फर्स्ट विदाउट एंड देन विद अ लोड। इट इज़ पॉसिबल टू सेव मास्टरिंग डेटा फॉर डिफरेंट लोड्स। ASIC इज नॉट मास्टर्ड यूजिंग द MEMD, but with the aid of a mark. The procedure is described in the sections describing MEMD mastering. Step 1. First mastering is carried out without a load. Second, teach offset is carried out with a load. The difference from the first mastering is saved. Third, if required, master load with offset. Load mastering with offset is carried out with a load for which an offset has already been taught. Area of application: checking first mastering, restoring first mastering if it has been lost. Since an offset that has been taught is retained even if mastering is lost, the robot controller can calculate the first mastering. MEMD. MEMD case: 1. MEMD box. 2nd screwdriver, 3rd MEMD, 4th cable. The thinner cable is the signal cable. It connects the MEMD to the MEMD box. The thicker cable is the either CAT cable. It is connected to the MEMD box and to the robot at X32. Notice: leave the signal cable connected to the MEMD box and disconnect it as little as possible. The pluggability of the M8 sensor connector is limited. Frequent connector disconnection can result in damage to the connector. Next is first mastering with MEMD. Precondition: there is no load on the robot. There is no tool, workpiece or supplementary load mounted. A1 to A5 are in the pre-mastering position. No program is selected. Operating mode T1. Procedure: in the main menu, select startup master EMD with load correction first mastering. A window opens. All access to be mastered are displayed. The access with the lowest number is highlighted. Remove the cover from connection X32. Connect the either CAT cable for 2X32 and to the MEMD box. Remove the protective cap of the gauge cartridge on the axis highlighted in the window. Screw the MEMD onto the gauge cartridge. Press master. Press an enabling switch and the start key. When the MEMD has passed through the reference notch, the mastering position is calculated. The robot stops automatically. The values are saved. The axis is no longer displayed in the window. Remove the MEMD from the gauge cartridge and replace the protective cap. Repeat steps 4 through 8 for all axes to be mastered except A6. Close the window. Move A6 to the mastering position. A6 has very fine marks in the metal. Align these marks exactly with one another. When moving to the mastering position, it is important to look at the fixed mark in a straight line from in front. If the mark is observed from the side, the movable mark cannot be aligned accurately enough. This results in incorrect mastering. In the main menu, select startup, master, reference. The option window reference mastering is opened. A6 is displayed and is selected. Press master. A6 is mastered and removed from the open option window. Close the window. Disconnect the either CAT cable from X32 and the MEMD box. Notice: leave the signal cable connected to the MEMD box and disconnect it as little as possible. The pluggability of the M8 sensor connector is limited. Frequent connection disconnection can result in damage to the connector. Next is teach offset with MEMD. Description: teach offset is carried out with a load. The difference from the first mastering is saved. If the robot is operated with different loads, teach offset must be carried out for every load. In the case of grippers used for picking up heavy work pieces, teach offset must be carried out for the gripper both with and without the workpiece. Precondition: same ambient conditions temperature as for first mastering, the load is mounted on the robot. A1 to A5 are in the pre-mastering position. No program is selected. Operating mode T1. Procedure. Select startup, master, EMD with load correction, teach offset in the main menu. Enter tool number. Confirm with tool OK. A window opens. All access for which the tool has not yet been taught are displayed. The access with the lowest number is highlighted. Remove the cover from connection X32. Connect the either CAT cable to X32 and to the MEMD box. Remove the protective cap of the gauge cartridge on the axis highlighted in the window. Screw the MEMD onto the gauge cartridge. Press Learn. Press an enabling switch and the start key. When the MEMD has passed through the reference notch, the mastering position is calculated. The robot stops automatically. A window opens. The deviation of this axis from the first mastering is indicated in degrees and increments. Click on OK to confirm. The axis is no longer displayed in the window. Remove the MEMD from the gauge cartridge and replace the protective cap. Repeat steps 5 to 10 for all axes to be mastered except A6. Close the window. Move A6 to the mastering position. A6 has very fine marks in the metal. Align these marks exactly with one another. When moving to the mastering position, it is important to look at the fixed mark in a straight line from in front. If the mark is observed from the side, the movable mark cannot be aligned accurately enough. This results in incorrect mastering. In the main menu, select Startup, Master, Reference. The option window Reference Mastering is opened. A6 is displayed and is selected. Press Master. A6 is mastered and removed from the option window. Close the window. Disconnect the EtherCAT cable from X32 and the MEMD box. Notice. Leave the signal cable connected to the MEMD box and disconnect it as little as possible. The pluggability of the MH sensor connector is limited. Frequent connection disconnection can result in damage to the connector. That's it for today's video. In the next video, we will continue from check load mastering with offset with MEMD.